I am Dr. H.R. Nagendra, Chancellor, Swami Vivekananda Yoga Anusandhan Samsthan, SVASA Deemed Yoga University. Yoga has reached great heights in India. The International Day of Yoga brought not thousands, but in lakhs. And the last year, it went to 18 crores of people. And next year, probably it may go even to 20, 25 crores of people. And therefore, yoga has gone into every household, into every nook and corner of India. Thanks to our brilliant speech by our Honorable Prime Minister on the holistic vision of yoga, the International Day of Yoga has been accepted by UNO and large number of countries have accepted. And it is being celebrated every year on June 21st. So last year, probably the Ministry of External Affairs brought this to largest number of countries. A few countries left. Next year it's going to be probably for every country in the world. That is the global spread of yoga that is coming up. As many of you know, I was in University of British Columbia and then went to NASA in Marshall Space Flight Center working on the space shuttle project. From there I came to Harvard, in which I worked on the dimensions related to spread of the flames, fire hazards that are coming up. And then how to simulate this in the computers. I was in Imperial College of Science and Technology. This gave me a background as to how and what is happening in the world of science and technology. And I understood also the limitations and advantages. To overcome the limitations, to meet the new challenges that are coming up in the world at large, we need to understand and develop our dimension. To move from the present matter-based paradigm to consciousness-based paradigm, from upward causation to downward causation, as Professor Amit Swami tells us. And this is where we have to move, and the whole world is moving in that direction to understand the subtler and causal dimensions of this entire universe. And it is this that triggered me to set up this yoga university also here. Modern science has fathomed the entire physical world. Over the 400 years, Newton and Descartes, who started the ball rolling, has grown to great heights, and we have entered into the era of science and technology. We have understood what every object is made of, and we also know the laws that govern them. Every object made out of molecules, protons, neutrons, electrons, fundamental particles, and made of quarks, energy, packets of energy. Then the laws that govern them is the Newton's laws of motion. That's called deterministic approach, classical mechanics. But when you go to extremely high speeds, like an electron swirling around the nucleus, then we have to go to the higher law, special theory of relativity, quantum mechanics, and probabilistic mechanics. So the science is in a turning point to go now beyond the physical. It's here that yoga spirituality comes into picture, and that's what triggered me to fathom the understanding of yoga spirituality and have the holistic vision of the entire human system. We are not just the physical body. We have got four more bodies, it tells. Pranamaya kosha, manomaya, vijnana, anandamaya kosha, apart from the annamaya kosha, the physical body. And that's what we have to fathom today, and giving a new direction to science itself. And thereby, we meet the new challenges that are emerging, which are multidimensional in character. When I returned, I was in Kanyakumari, Vivekananda Kendra. And under the leadership of Sri Eknaji Ranade, who built this beautiful rock memorial in the Mid-Sea Rock, I was able to get the direction as to how we have to bring this yoga dimension into the field of education. And we went to the Northeast, Arunachal Pradesh, and brought the people who are in the lowest step of evolution into the best mainstream children by using the yoga techniques. Objective of education is to build the total personality, and as Swami Vivekananda said, we must add on man-making education to the bread-earning education. And it is this that triggered me to develop the specialized integrated yoga modules to bring the total personality development, eyesight improvement, voice culture, hearing development, memory development, IQ development, creativity development, and anger management, greed management, stress management. We develop one after another yoga modules to be produced into the primary and secondary education in Arunachal. And what a result we got. Thanks to Swamiji's and the wonderful dedicated team of Vivekananda Kendra, these children were brought to the mainstream, and they are the most needed children today in the world at large. And then we entered into the higher education system. And the UGC said, we have to have the syllabus for this. And we started developing the syllabus. With the help of all the yoga masters in the country, we were able to bring this dimension at large. That's where this university took shape and got the deemed university status in 2002. And it is now 2022, is our 20th year celebrations. And we were able to bring this entire dimension of yoga and its benefit to people at large, and the wide vista of yoga by 5 divisions. Division of yoga on spirituality, division of yoga on life sciences, yoga management studies, physical sciences, and humanities. And in all these things, the UG and the PG and the PhD programs have been started, and we have a galaxy of team, the faculty who are able to bring out these dimensions of the holistic vision of yoga into all these fields. And research is the main base. Swami Vivekananda said, combine the best of the East with the best of the West. Best of the West is modern scientific research. Best of the East is yoga, spirituality. And this had to be combined together to bring a new effervescence in the world at large. And that is what we have been able to do here. And we have nearly 250 people doing their doctorate here, and nearly 2,000 people do their master's degree, both on the offline and the online mode. And we're expanding it further throughout the world. It has gone into Japan, Singapore, China, and nearly 80 countries. It has started growing, and this is how we are spreading this grand wisdom of our ancient India, an ocean of knowledge that we have. And the secrets have to be unraveled and brought to the people at large. And that's how we are spreading everywhere. That is the role of this university that we have set up, very, very unique university in the world, where we have the best research lab, which is also the most unique. Nowhere in the world we have this total understanding of the research to fathom not only what is happening in the physical body, but at the prana level, mind level, emotional level, intellectual level. And we have the total knowledge base that is being researched on, bringing the evidence base to all that we talk about and introduce here. Yoga has its benefits to everyone in the society. Yoga has a message for all. And therefore, in the health scenario, we are facing a big challenge of the non-communicable diseases. Modern medical world has fathomed wonderfully well, bringing very powerful pharmacological interventions and surgical interventions. With 5,000 types of surgery available today, we can replace every part of the body. Even we are replacing the gene to completely change the personality. But we have not been able to meet the challenge of asthma, diabetes, hypertension, heart problem, epilepsy, migraine, irritable bowel syndrome, cancer, and whatnot. Once a diabetic, ever a diabetic. Once you have hypertension, it's for your life. Once you have cancer, your days have numbered have to come. Why? Because the modern medical world is based on modern science, which is essentially having the knowledge base of the physical world. And these modern challenges of NCDs are not merely physical. Mental restlessness, emotional upsurges, deep-rooted psychological conflict, all are at the base of these NCDs and stress challenges. Therefore, we need a holistic vision of yoga which deals with not only the physical body, at the mind, emotions, intellect, with a spiritual basis. It gives you the holistic dimension. So it's a multidimensional challenge we face with a multidimensional approach that we have. That is what we are doing here. So in the integrated approach of yoga therapy in our Arogyadhama, a 400-bed facility, we have been able to deal with all such complicated cases, and they get fantastic results. Then we said we have to bring in the dimension of Ayurveda, the age-old science, which are thousands of years old, based on this consciousness-based approach again. And we brought naturopathy and physiotherapy, acupuncture, all under one roof we can get here as an integrated health delivery system.